The behavior of the stack of coins in the drop tower under zero-g conditions is one of my favorite examples of drop tower physics. Normally, when the coins are sitting on the surface, we have weight and normal force acting on the coins. This is why this becomes such a beautiful example for use in your classroom explaining the nature of the normal force. Most students, when you ask them what would happen during drop, would probably predict that the coins would remain stationary on the bottom of the drop tower box. This is because we've taught our students over and over again that all objects fall freely at the same rate, irrespective of their mass. This is, of course, a direct consequence of Newton's second law. What force causes free fall? Weight. And weight is mass times the acceleration of gravity. What mass on the right controls acceleration? Inertial mass. And the mass on the left is normally called gravitational mass because it is how mass interacts with the gravitational field G to produce weight. Now, the principle of equivalence says that inertial mass and gravitational mass are identical, so they cancel on both sides, giving us the fact that the acceleration of all bodies in free fall is the acceleration due to gravity. This might be why your students mostly would have predicted that the coins would remain stationary during drop. However, we suddenly saw that the coins jumped up into the air. Why was it then that the coins jumped up into the air? Before drop, we had weight and normal force acting on the coins, and it was in equilibrium. What caused the normal force? Well, the normal force is caused because when you place the coins on the surface is deformed by the weight of the coins. And that deformation and the distance associated with that deformation, x, is represented by elastic potential energy inside of the floor. When weight is suddenly removed, the elastic potential energy remains, and that energy is then converted to kinetic energy in the coins as the distance of deformation of the floor decreases to zero. This shoots the coins up into the air with velocity. What actually happens is that at the moment of drop, a shock wave travels through the coins and reaches the top of the coins, reflecting off the top, coming back down and pushing on the bottom coin, holding it stationary on the floor while the other coins move upward and come to a stop during the drop. What is amazing is that when the box decelerates at the rate of 15 G's, this causes the stack of coins to come slamming back into the floor and, amazingly enough, does not topple over. So overall, this process creates a situation which it provides a very good example of the normal force and the source of the normal force being the deformation of the floor for your classroom use. Also, students might notice that it does seem like when Wile E. Coyote in the cartoon runs off the cliff and doesn't fall for a certain period of time, that that might be actually the behavior of nature. Well, I think it's probably a violation of the laws of physics.